I always think it's fun to do lollipops. It's relatively easy. You do need to have a candy thermometer, which you can pick up at several things. This happens to be one made by Wilton. You can probably get it at craft stores or wherever they. And you just have to make sure, like when this sits in the pan, you see the thermometer doesn't touch the bottom of the pan, so you're not checking the temperature of the pan, you're checking the temperature of what you have in it. Because some of the older ones, you know, the clip's like gone, and all of a sudden the thermometer rests against the pan and you get not a good temperature reading. Okay, we're going to put in, I better put my glasses on for this, okay. We are going to put in our sugar, our corn syrup, and our butter in a little saucepan, heat this up. Now you do want to use a wooden spoon, or this is a rubber spatula that is silicone, so it is like temperature resistant to 500 degrees or whatever. You do not want to use this, because that is not temperature, and you'll get temperature resistant. Okay, so we're going to stir this up in here till it kind of dissolves a little bit. I've got it on high right now, but I'm going to turn it down once it gets kind of started. So we've got our 1/4 cup of butter, our 3/4 cup of sugar, and our 1/2 cup of light corn syrup in here. We're going to put some cherry gelatin. That'll give us the flavoring and the color. And while we're letting that kind of melt, we'll get our pan ready. And there's nothing really too different about getting the pan. It's good to do it on the foil. And that's just for easy removal. This is really, really hot when we get it boiling. So you don't want to put it on wax paper, or you want to make sure you have something that's pretty sturdy to put it on. Okay. Might even want to do this on a flat thing, because now I just have some popsicle sticks that we're going to use. And you're just, I like to spray this. This just helps remove them a little bit. Makes it just a little bit easier. But we're just going to put our popsicle sticks. We'll just do a few. You don't want them too close together. We'll just do that. Okay. And it's said to use a metal teaspoon to kind of dip it out, which I have right here. Tablespoon. Did I say teaspoon? Tablespoon. And that's because the liquid is hot. I like that. This happens to be mine from home. It's got a little rubber handle, so it doesn't, you know, because anything metal you put in here is going to heat right up. And it's going to be too hot to handle. All right, so we've got our tray ready. We've got our lollipop mixture going. We're going to go ahead and take this out of the box and get it ready, although we've got a while till this gets up to, we want it up to about 275. I'm going to open this and try not to knock it over. But I'm not going to guarantee anything. Okay. I'm going to put this in. Okay. It does have a clip on the back. We're just going to rest it in here. So the tip is just kind of touching. Okay. Can you see that in the? Now it's starting to boil. You want to stir it every once in a while. You don't have to keep continually stirring it. And with an electric stove, you just have to remember that when your heating element, you know, I've got it on high. It's not going to just keep heating. So you need to just kind of watch it because it's going to take a little bit of time to heat up. I'm going to turn it down just a little bit. But when you use an electric stove, you know, it heats up and then it cools down, then heats up and cools down, heats up. So it takes a little bit longer. With a gas stove, it would just keep heating. So you want to make sure that you don't have it on high all the time or you'll burn your liquid before it's ready. Okay, it's up to about 200 degrees. We'll let that go for a little bit. We got that ready. All right. I think we are ready here. Turn that off. Get rid of that. Stir our jello in. Ooh, smells like cherry. You can use strawberry if you like, or raspberry, or... But for Valentine's Day, we need a cherry or something red. So we're just going to stir that till the gelatin dissolves. Now, again, this is very hot. So you want to be very, very careful. You do not want to go like that. We're just going to take our little metal spoon, put it over. I can do better than that. If you kind of pile it up and then sort of spread it out, it makes it more round. We gotta fix that one. Now you can put little, as this is hardening, you can put little candies in. You have to watch what you put in. You don't want to put any chocolate chips in there. And you can kind of work it to a... And if you're worried about burning yourself or if you forget that this is really, really hot, it's a good idea to have a little bowl of ice water. So in case the hot sugar mixture gets on your hands, you can kind of stick it in the ice water and that'll help. Okay. A little misshapen, but... And you can put these like in little heart bags that they have. Okay. I'll make a couple more just to... That's some stuff I dropped on the burner. It's smoking and smelling. So I've got, what, 6, 8 here, and there's quite a bit left. I'm going to go ahead and leave that for now. All right, so there's our little lollipops, and they're going to harden in a few minutes. And if you were really good, you could put this down on here, pour the mixture in, kind of let it harden a little bit, and then slip a little bit, and then slip the stick in. But you have to be right on top of it, because it hardened faster than I thought. That's why the lollipop samples that you have no sticks in them. Because I thought, oh, I'll pour it all, and then I'll go back and put the sticks in. You can't do that. So I tested that little theory. So you don't have to worry about it.